Okay, so 10th standard students, this video is the continuation of your last video. Okay, in the last video we have started with the geography part, social science part 2 geography part, and the chapter name is chapter 10th number chapter, and the chapter name is India Industries. In the last video we have done, not done totally but partially, means half of the things we have done. That is the, we are now going through the meaning and importance of industries in India, not in India, industries as a whole. Okay, so what is that? Growth of industries plays an important role. Okay, then industries are the place where raw materials are bringing, we bring the raw material there to get the output as goods or commodity. The word industry comes from the Latin industria, that is diligence, which means hard work. Okay, and then we have concluded with the four types of industries. They are the primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary. Primary deals with the raw materials, it involves in with the processing, or not processing, it involves in getting the raw materials. Secondary, it involves in the manufacturing, and the tertiary, they involves in the service. And the fourth one is the quaternary, they involves themselves in the research and development. So now we will be going with the same. If we are in the same part, that is the meaning and importance, we should know the industrial system. What is the system of these industries? Factories have inputs and outputs. Okay, factories, any factories, if you go, you can check it there, that they are having the inputs. With the help of processing through different technologies and skill, they are getting the output. Okay, so input are the factors of production, such as capital, labor, land and entrepreneurship. Okay, what are the inputs? Inputs are the factors of production. What is needed for production? They are capital, labor, land and entrepreneurship. Now we will go for the output. Output are the finished things or materials that leaves the factory. Once your product is done, what you will do? You will sell it to the market for selling. Means finished product. Okay. So output are the finished things or material that leaves the factory. Means finished product. For the development of an industry, the following factors are very much essential. Okay, for the development of factories, these are the input and output is required. Okay, they are the prime or primary factors of production. Okay, but there are many other factors which are mainly involved so that we can do the production. If they are not favorable, then that industry will not be having sufficient growth. For the development of an industry, the following factors are very much essential. What are those factors? Mineral resources. If I am having a iron and steel industry, the main thing is that I need that raw material. Suppose I am having everything but I don't have the iron ore, then there is no question that I can produce steel. Okay, so mineral resources, raw materials. Okay, mineral resources for the industries who deals with the minerals only. Okay, so then raw materials, see, it is a cotton industry. Okay, suppose I am having a cloth industry, so my main thing is that I will get the thread. So the thread, where, from where it will come? It will come from the cotton plant. Ideal climate is also a factor for the production. Okay, good transportation should be good. Means if I don't have the transportation, how I will send the finished product to the market? Okay, then wide market and modern technology. Wide market should be there. Suppose I am having the finished product, I am having the transportation also, but where I will send? I will send it to that market where there is a huge demand of that product. And modern technology, what happens? It makes the commodity cheap. Okay, how it happens? Means suppose I am having a machinery it see the industry is mainly depends on the machinery. Okay, if the machineries are outdated means very old, so what will happen, it will consume more power, so that will affect the price of the product. But if I am having a modern technological equipment or machinery, what will happen, it will consume less of the this one power and everything, so I can give the product to the market by giving in less money, so the product will be cheap. So what are the main factors? Those are the primary factors are capital, land, labor and entrepreneurship. Okay, so they are the primary factor. Apart from that, we need mineral resources, raw material, ideal climate, good transportation system, wide market and modern technology. Many natural resources and raw materials cannot be utilized directly. There are many raw materials, okay, and natural resources also are there which we can't use directly, okay. They have to be processed or refined, okay. They have to be processed or refined. We are getting the raw material, see, we are getting iron ore, we can't use it as a steel or iron, okay. We have to process it in the factory, then only we will be getting that iron or steel. So many natural resources and raw materials cannot be utilized directly. So they have to be processed or refined. For example, sugar cane into sugar. Okay, sugar cane we use, but sugar cane we can't use to make paisam. Okay, we need sugar that time. So the sugar cane is the main raw material for the sugar industry, and with the help of that sugar cane being processing it and refining it, we get the sugar. So it is not used raw, it is processed and then only we are getting that sugar. So what happened? So they have to be processed or refined. For example, sugar cane into sugar, iron ore into steel, cotton into cloth. Okay, raw cotton we can't use as a shirt or trouser or churidar or whatever the dress materials we are having, we can't use that cotton. Okay, that has to be processed and then only we will be getting the output of the finished product. Wood pulp into paper, we can't use wood pulp as a paper, we can't write on the wood pulp, but that wood pulp is used in the factory to get the paper. So the conversion of raw material into usable product is known as manufacturing industry. So the conversion, it is converted, that raw material is converted in such a way and it is processed or refined in such a way that we will get the output which is very much beneficial and usable by the individuals of the country. Okay, so the conversion of raw material into usable product is known as manufacturing industry. Okay, so what is manufacturing industry? Manufacturing industry, they get the raw material, they process it, refine it, and then only they get the finished product, okay, which is very much usable for the people. Industries helps for the reduction of imported goods. If your industries are here, means we are having the products, whatever the industry, okay. So we are having that product with us, okay. So it helps in reducing the import. Suppose my country don't have something which we have to import from other countries. Maybe other countries, they are producing it, so we have to import it. Import it means taking it from other country, and export means giving it to other country. We import what we don't have and we export what we have, that is excess we are having. First we will fulfill the need, or we will satisfy the customers or the people of the country, and then the excess amount we will be exporting it. Okay, so industries helps for the reduction of imported goods. When it is reducing the imported goods, then if it is produced in huge amount, it will encourage for the export also. Okay, it so industries helps in reduction of imported goods and encourage the export of goods. Okay, and thus help in the increase the national and per capita income and earn in foreign exchange. So what happened? It reduces the this one. It reduces the import of other goods from other country. Okay, and if we are having the industry, we can produce some goods in huge amount. So what will happen? We can export it. So what it will do? It will give almost industries are growing means we are getting the jobs. We are giving the money to the people as salary, wages, whatever you tell. Okay, so it helps to increase the national and per capita income. National income will be high. So once the national income will be high, the per capita income means income of an individual, it is also increasing. And if we are doing the export of the excess product, what will happen? The foreign exchange means the foreign money will come to our country. Also create job opportunities and raise GDP and the living standard of the people of India. What is happening? It increase the employment within the country. And once the employment, it is actually what is GDP? GDP is nothing but the gross domestic product. So industries are there means more products are getting. Okay, so automatically the GDP will get raised and the living standard of the people of India. It increases the living standard of the people of the country. We will be discussing, we are discussing here about India. Okay, so it what it happens? It gives employment, it increases the per capita income, it increases the GDP. Actually what happened? They are all interconnected. Once GDP is, once you get the employment, it means the country is getting the development. How we will get the employment? Only if industries are growing more, or even the agricultural sector, any sector is growing means the country's GDP, means the gross domestic product, is increasing. Okay, and as a result what will happen? Once your income is increasing means the standard of living, means three times the basic necessities we can fulfill, means food, clothes, shelter. Along with that we can do other, means we can access to other goods also. We will be having good health, we will be having good education. These are very much necessary. They also help to reduce the pressure on agriculture. Okay, India is an agricultural country, but what happened? We can't depend on agriculture only. Okay, means something alternatives will come, means it reduce the pressure on that sector. So if the industries are growing, it means that if suppose one is there, if one person is a income person in my family, if my father is only in the person who is doing the income, but if my mother is also doing the income, so what will happen? More inflow of cash will happen. So the pressure on my father will be less. The same thing is that industries also help to reduce the pressure on agriculture. Industries are vital for economic progress. Okay, agriculture is there, but these industries are very much vital for economic progress. So in the next video we will be discussing about the localization of industries and major industrial regions. Okay, so with this we have concluded the meaning and importance of industries. So go through the notes, you will understand easily, because the note is in very simple language. Then also if you are feeling any problem, you can feel free to come here to clarify your doubts. Okay, so see you in the next video, and thank you, have a nice day.